So the first speaker this morning will be Gustavo Ponce from the University of California, Santa Barbara, who was Klainerman's first student. And he will speak about special properties of solutions to the generalized KdV equation.
Thank you, Hans. Well, first I would like to thank the organizer, Peter, Igor, Mihalis, and Alexi for the invitation. It's a great honor to be part of this conference. As Han mentioned, I was Sergio's first student, and his previous speaker and in the banquet, they talk about Sergio's vision and enthusiasm. I would like to, as a former student, I would like to add two things that were very close to me. It was that the generosity that Sergio showed as an advisor. He has infinite time and infinite willing to share knowledge with when I was a student. Also, he has incredible patience with me, and that was not restricted to math. It was beyond that for reasons that have to do with politics and things like that.
You have to say how you went back to Venezuela despite my advice.
Okay, well, better talk about KdV. Okay, we are going to be talking about the generalized KdV equation. And of course, this is a 19th century equation, and then it will be hard to say something new, but I will still try. Right? We will be talking about this initial value problem. And let me write it here because we will. It's known that for power 1 and 2, this is integrable model. That's not the case for any other powers. And we shall discuss, I will try to motivate what is the S that we are going to take. Then to do that, then I have to tell you, in some sense, which are the best result known for the well-posedness of this equation. Then this is a power k, well-posedness, okay, let me write it. Let me write it here. This is the power. This is the well-posedness. Local, this is the global well-posedness, and this is the scaling. And the scaling is what is known is for power 1, you have the best local result is -3/4, the best global result is minus. For power 2, the best is 1/4, local and global. And here, I will put that. For k equal to 3, the best is global. Local is this one, and since global is this one. And now you reach this. You're okay. And if k is larger or equal to 4, you reach the scaling. And of course, you don't have global, at least in k equal to 4, that is a major result by Frammer and Ivan Martel. Then you have a curiosity fact that the power 1 and the power 3 are better than the power 2. If you have followed the previous talk whenever the power or the dimension go in one direction, always. The scaling tells you that, right? Then you don't expect to have something like this. It's a curious fact.
Sorry, I didn't quite get what's happening for k larger than 4?
Okay, k larger than 4, you have the scaling. The local well-spotness is what you expect for the scaling. Global, you don't have global, at least for k equal to 4, this is a Mer-Martel, and then this is exactly what you get, the scaling. Okay, I don't think that there is too many equations that have this curious fact, but we're going to see one more. Okay. Okay, after all this discussion, you will be a little be disappointed that I'm not going to use such a nice numbers. Right? We are going to use something completely different. We are going to try to work with energy estimate. And if you recall, the quantity in the energy estimate that you have to control is that one. Suppose that you want to work with energy estimate here. Right? So in energy estimate, you don't use that. This is an exclusive metric, then you are working with this part. This is an issue in our method. And then you ask what is the smallest s that you need, at least in the linear case, to control this quantity. Then you go back to the Stricker estimate. And this is something that we proved some time ago with Carlos and Luis. And you recall that in the linear problem, the solution is given by convolution with the Airy function, and the symbol have more curvature than the case of the Schrodinger equation, then you have more room to gain. In particular, you gain derivatives. In the Schrodinger equation, you don't gain derivatives. Yeah, you gain more because your curvature is different. You have a cube, not a quadratic parabola. Then, in particular, you gain one quarter of derivatives in an infinity. Okay? Okay, I apologize, I return. I'm not going to give credit to this result. Most of the people who have proof here have talked, but they are not here. But I promise that I will mention results here that for the people that are sitting here. Mark. This result, strictly larger, was proved by Koliander, Kiel, Takaoka, Staffilani, and Tao. And the equality was proved by Kachimoto and Guo. Is that correct? Yeah. Okay, then all this info has been done for previous speaker. Right? I will not talk about that. And I apologize to my collaborators. Okay, then, since we gain one quarter of derivatives, we are going to assume that this is half three quarter. In fact, we are going to assume this. And then our local theorem, and we are going to assume that we have the solution. We aren't by any means looking for solution. We are discussing property of a given solution. Then, given a initial data that have more than 3/4 derivatives, the 3/4 plus only appear in one case when k is equal to 1, but let's leave it like this. Then there exists a time such that the solution describes a continuous curve in that subtle space have the Stricker estimate that you want. This is number 2. The number 3 is that you have the local smoothing effect of Kato type. And the number 4 is that you have the maximal function. And that's the restriction why do you need 3/4 plus. Moreover, you prove you can prove all these results, even that you can do it with energy estimate. You can also prove it by using the contraction principle in the energy, in the integral equation. And in that case, the mapped data solution is smooth. Right? Then this is we are going to assume that we have this result. Okay? And of course, there are a few remarks that we need to make. If k is equal to 1, 2, 3, and you combine several results, you have that t can take it arbitrarily large. K equal to 4 is not the case. K larger than 4 is open. Right? And you have this trivial remark, but this is very important. If you start with a better data that have more than 3/4 derivatives, you will stay forever there. But if you are not there at the beginning, you will never be there. Okay? It's completely trivial, but it will be important later on. Then our first result is the following. Suppose that you have a data that satisfies that you have a local existence. And suppose that there exists M and there exists such that this happens. That locally you have more regularity. Then what happened is that this regularity that you have here immediately propagate in this direction, forward in time. Right? Then with infinite speed, but with to positive time, you will have that in this part, you still are in L2 when HM all the way you want. Okay. That means that all the regularity that you have here measured in this form will move like this with infinite speed. Okay. Moreover, even if you only have n derivatives locally here, you will have n plus 1 derivatives locally in some strip that move. Okay, then since you cannot improve, you cannot get, suppose that you are here, even that you are in HM in all this line as long as you wish this way, you are not in H1 in the whole line. Then the issue is that you don't have, you have the regularity here. In fact, you have the regularity everywhere, but you don't have the decay in this direction. That's the reason why you are not in HM. In fact, you can prove the following. If you begin with this regularity, but not this one global, but this one local, then if you held the function to decay to minus infinity, then you will be integrable. And this is the quantity that you need to make it. Then you will be in some HM weighted in the left side. Okay. Let's recall that in this equation decay imply regularity. Well, it depends how you measure. Okay. We are not talking about decay, we are talking about regularity implied for the regularity, right? Okay, let's see a corollary of this sort. Let me give you a picture. Suppose that we have a data. This will be putting the corollary together. Suppose that we have a data suppose that for some alpha and some beta here. And suppose that here you have, your solution is not C1. Particularly, you are not C2. You are not H2. Then what can you say when the time advances? Well, since you are in HM, in that direction and in that one, immediately this singularity disappears forward and backward. You don't see this singularity again, neither in the future nor in the past. However, you will not, since you have this singularity here, for each time that you have, for time, let me put minus t here, yeah, and for any a positive, you will have that b sub zero is not in H2, B of t is not in H2, A infinity. For any t, you cannot be in H2, doesn't matter where do you start here. Because if you were here, you apply the theorem and that will not appear. And also, since the k apply this, you don't have this. You cannot have in any, and the same thing happen in this side. Then you have a complete picture that this regularity travels this way, this regularity travels that way, but you don't have this because that, and you don't have that. Okay, this is. In some sense, there is a, in some book, in inverse scattering, they make a statement that say that given some data, the nice guy moved to the right, and the singularity moved to the left. I mean, this is look like a political statement, right? But the good guys are the solitons, and the bad guy, I imagine, that are the singularity. We will see that this is not true. A statement like that. You have to make it precise this way because it's not true. Okay, there is another thing that you can prove is sometimes you see that you need to have decay to perform some properties of the solution, but if you ask decay at two times, you are asking regularity global. Well, the second corollary, we proved that even for the KDV, you can start in L2, but if you assume that you have decay that is symmetric at two times, then you really have global regularity. Then you can, if you have decay in this direction, and in the future you have it in this direction, you have the same result. You don't need this something symmetric anymore. Okay, this is the second corollary of that. Okay, let's go back to our theorem and ask few questions. This is our theorem, and say if you start with more than 3/4 derivatives and you have, you are in HM, but M has to be integer, then you have what you want. The regularity moves to the left with infinite speed. Do you need to be an integer? Well, the answer is no. You don't need to be an integer. Anything that more than 3/4 will move, but the proof is more complicated. Because you are, okay. Okay. Then the second question is that restricted to work with the KDV? Is maybe is that restricted because you have the AD function has some property, right? Or maybe because you are close to be an integrable system or something. Well, let's see that this is not the case, right? And then we have our second equation that is the Hilbert transform, and involve the Hilbert transform that is the Benjamin Ono equation. Okay, this is in the case that the power is one here, that you have quadratic nonlinearity, this is integrable, at least formally. And this equation has the following property. I mean, if the path, they have several properties that are related with the KDV, and one is that the path, this is the power, this is the well postness, and this is the scaling. And since I am going to, the scaling gives you k, suggests that this should be the value of the well postness. However, this is not the case. Okay, the well postness goes for this equation that if k is equal to 1, that you are in, you can go to L2, and this is a result of Ionescu and Kenny. And you have the same curious fact that power 1 and 3 are better than 2. Okay. Then this equation has the same property that if you can perform energy estimate here, and to perform energy estimate you need which is very unpleasant because you are not using that. This is exactly what, right? But it's a fact that you can, instead, this equation can be solved by contraction, using the contraction principle in the integral equation. This cannot be done. And this is a result of Molinetto and Zetko, right? Then this has the same property that if you have extra regularity here, that moves with infinite speed in that direction. The same regular, the same theorem holds. Then you can now say that, well, maybe because you are all the time close to something that is integrable. And in fact, well, before we go to this slice, is how I'm not going to get into the proof of the result. When you try to prove, the idea is that you're going to use the Kato smoothing effect and truncate that and do the same idea. But when you try to do that here, you run into trouble because you have the Hilbert transform. However, if you know this estimate that this, then you everything is very simple because you are almost working exactly the same as the KDV. And the estimate is this one that is some generalization of Calderon commutator theorem. It says that if you commute the Hilbert transform with a nice multiplication function, you should have an operator of order minus one. But in fact, you have an operator of order minus whenever you want if this function is very nice. And this is a result for k, for j plus m equal to 1. This is Calderon's result. For j plus m larger than 1 is Koiman. Then if you use energy estimate here, and you mimic what we did here, you get the result for the Benjamin ono. This is the only new technique that you need, really, to pass from energy estimate KDV to prove it for the Benjamin. Well, okay. Okay, then you're going to say, well, this result that you have is too related. It's too related to integrable models. Then they have to do something with integrability. Well, to make it also applied to an equation that is a two-dimensional integrable equation, again, integrability appear, that is called the KP2, right? And in fact, you can go to this equation that is called the generalized dispersive equation that the best result are due to Daniel Tataro and Ionescu in combination with Koenig and it's a four auto, right? The three of you? It's not you? Okay, I'm sorry. The best local existence theorem for that is not due to Ionescu. No? Okay. I don't know that. In any case, you ask, is the same result that the regularity propagate with infinite speed to the left known? Well, this is only true when this equation that you have there, that you write this parameter alpha to model the dispersion is equal to zero, that means that you have the Benjamin ono equation, or when it's equal to one, that you have the KDV. That means that is everything to be seen related with integrability. Okay, now let's see that this is not the case. Let's take this general quasi-linear KDV equation that far from integrability, I mean, and of course you assume that the coefficient of the third order derivatives is a nice function, and this the one that includes derivatives up to order 2, and you assume that you have that A satisfies on this dispersion order, and you don't have the backward parabolicity. Okay. This is the very natural assumption that you have there. If you assume that, you have the following result that is due to Craig Capellari-Strauss, is that the problem, the initial value problem associated to this equation, that is this one, number 13, have a unique solution that has that property, and you need to assume that you have more than 7 derivatives. And if you work with very low regularity, 7 should bother you, but if you go to the method, this is 7 is the place. That's it. Okay, this is, if you need to apply our result, we need a little bit some weak continuity of the solution respect to the data, and then we achieve this by following the result and doing some trick. And once that you have this, then you can say that the same result holds, and this is a joint work with Linares and Smith, He says that the same thing happened for the quasi-linear KdV equation. If you have seven derivatives here, but you have much more in this side, this propagates in that direction. That means that integrability is not, has nothing to do with that. Okay, then the next question it will be, if you have a solution of this equation, and if there is only other possible regularities that propagate or are preserved with the flow, you know that if you are in this space, you are preserved forward and backward, then you know that if you are in this space, you are preserved forward, and so, right? Then you ask, is any other regularity that you propagate with that? Then let's see first that the following result that is due to Bon and So, and well, they prove that for the case of two points, and they claim that it can be proved. Then we gave a different proof, and then you can, the theorem say the following. You can construct a solution here that exists it should be B. Such that the solution is C1 when t is not an integer, and when t is an integer, you are C1 in the whole space minus zero, but you are not C1 in zero. That means that you have a singularity that appear, disappear, appear, disappear, and so forth. Then the idea that regularity propagates with the flow, that is something that, a statement that appears in integrability is not true. You cannot ask for this. You have this singularity that appear. Then there is no, this kills the possibility of any local regularity to propagate. Right? And in fact, with this proof, we gave a different proof of this theorem. And this proof extends even to the subwoofer space when p is larger than 2. Right? What does that mean? That it means the following. You can have an extra regularity that is measured in LP, P more than 2, and this extra regularity will not propagate to the right or to the left. Right? Forward or backward, you will not have that. You can construct solutions that will do that for you. Okay.
What does the question mark mean?
Oh, okay. Most of the people put the year where the paper appear. I will. I use when this paper is.
Okay.
When it's going to be published.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
But it is a theorem, and these are the authors.
Yeah. It is. I'm sorry. Okay. Then this is not hard to prove. In fact, I mean, it's a trick, it's a simple proof, one that you have the following fact. It's a very simple idea to prove a theorem of this sort. For example, let's try to see how you prove this theorem. You're going to say that the solution of this equation that this is in H1, Suppose that you are in H1. Suppose that you prove that if this is in H1, this is in H2. In fact, that this is a continuous curve. Then if you want to see C1 regularity, everyone has to come from the linear. And why do you, can you say that this is better? Well, that this is better than the linear case. Well, remember that you have one derivative here, but then you have this estimate. That is called the inhomogeneous smoothing effect, that is this one. Well, let me do it in the homogeneous case and you will see the difference. Then this one you gain one derivative with scatter smoothing effect with respect to the initial data, but you always gain double when you do the inhomogeneous. Then you have more extra regularity by this. If you use this, you can prove this first step, and then all the singularity will come from the linear case. I mean, it's very simple. Then there is a, then if you put all these theorems together, it seems that the only regularity that propagates is this in the whole space and this forward in time, or backward if you have it in the other side. Okay, then the last question is, there have been some models close related with the KDV, and then you can ask if you have some similar result of this source. The answer is no, and let's consider the first this equation that is called the BBM, and you obtain this equation basically by changing the time derivatives with the x derivatives, and if you do that, then you have this result. This equation is well posed in L2, no hard to prove. You have this result that say nothing happened in this equation. I mean, it's, well, what it say is if this is t equal to 0, and you are in L2 here, and locally you are in K, okay, did I use K? K is not a good one, but let's, K plus theta here, you will be the same regularity at any time that you stop. I mean, this nothing happened. Okay, and the same thing happened with this model that is called the DeGasperi prosody equation, that is also an integrable model, but in this case, you have to follow the fluid line. Then if you have the characteristic, start here, then you have as you are as regular as the data here. And the same thing happened with the Kamasa hole if you start with enough regularity. Then
what does that mean?
I'm sorry.
What do you mean by that if you start with?
Okay, then well there is an issue. In the Kamasa hole you have this solution, right? That are not, there are some picons. There are not 3/2. But the local solution is required this. There is a possibility to prove some weak result in this space, but the flow is not defined there. Then you have to accommodate to produce a local system that has the P constant like this. For the previous case, for the DP, you also have Picon solution like this, but you don't need to start here. You can start, you have local well-postness in some sense in a weaker space. Then you have that if you have a corner here, this corner will propagate. And this is the only singularity that will appear. Not for this one, you don't have a local system that include this special solution called Picons. Okay, you have it. This is a Bresan, Adrian Constantine. Prove the result in this space, but you don't have the flows. Okay. Well, after all this, even that we are off for a few months, I'm going to say happy birthday, Sergio.
Any questions?
These equations, well, some of them, you've shown us many equations. There are perhaps some equations with higher space dimension for which at least simulations suggest what is going on. There's some conjectures about higher space dimension, or is that just another world?
Well, for the KP equation that is two dimension, you have the same, but it's it move in X globally in Y, this the regularity, right? More general than that, I don't know. No, I mean, morally, it should be that if you can prove by integration by power, Cartesian-Smoothing effect, you should be able to get that for that equation. That's morally, it should be true.
Why is this Benjamin Ohm result you talked about again true? You said it's CK plus theta.
No, this is BBM.
BBM, yeah.
This is this equation. Instead of having the Hilbert transform, you have derivatives in T.
Yeah, yeah. Understand.
Well, the results say that if you are in L2, that you are well-postness in L2, and suppose that you have a localized regularity here, measured in these Holder spaces, this you stop at any future time here and you have the same. I mean that it propagates completely vertical. Okay.
Let's thank the speaker again. Thank you.